I very much appreciate being honored. Next time you can honor me by not having me follow Tim Scott. You know, if Ray Charles could only do a new version of that song. Hit the Road Barack has a nice nice sound to it. As some of you know, Wilmington is now my home. So welcome to Wilmington for the state convention. We're glad to have you here. I want to catch you up a little bit about the Fetzer family since I last saw many of you in mid-January. My son turned 11 months yesterday. He'll be a year July 2nd, and he is an absolute joy, and we are having a great time with him, and Katy and I have settled into private life. Some of you know that shortly after having left the chairman's office, I was diagnosed with a form of cancer called non-Hodgkin's lymphoma, and I am about halfway through my chemo treatment regimen. But I have a very good prognosis, and I want to tell you, just share with you a couple things about it personally. First of all, I want to share a couple things that have been great comfort to me. First of all, in 1 Thessalonians 5, 16 through 18, Paul is writing to the Christians in Thessalonica, and he says, "Pray without ceasing, rejoice in all things, because this is the will of God in your life." Now, I don't know why it was God's will for me to have cancer, but let me tell you about a couple things that have happened to me since then. It's brought me closer to my God. It's brought me closer to my wonderful wife. It's brought me closer to many friends and family, and it's deepened my faith in a way. I think God was finishing some things in my life. So it's hard to say that having cancer is a blessing, but I'm here to tell you that I count it as such. Another scripture that I've taken great comfort from is Exodus 14:14, and the context is the Israelites are backed up against the Red Sea, and Pharaoh's army is bearing down on them, and they start to lose faith, and they're whining and complaining to Moses, you know, why did you bring us out here? We were better off as slaves in Egypt. At least we were alive. We're going to die right here on the desert floor. And God comes to Moses and says, tell them that those men before them, they will never see again after that. And just tell them to be still, and I will fight this fight for them. So I'm just being still, and I'm letting God fight the fight. But thank you for your prayers. I feel them. I know you're doing it. It's been a great source of comfort to me. And also, a woman of which I can't imagine. I don't know how I lived 54 years without her. I would wait another 54 years to find her if I needed to. But please give a special thanks to my wife, Katy. So my personal message, I think, right now in my life is to be still. Let God fight the fight. That is not what I'm encouraging our party to do. And I'm not going to quote the Lord God Almighty on this one, but I am going to quote pretty close to that on this earth, Winston Churchill, who said, never, 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 never give in except to conscience and duty. Now, I'm not going to advise you about your conscience, but I'm going to tell you what your duty is. Now, at this time, I don't know how many of them are left because I had a long night last night till midnight, but if you're a member of the General Assembly of North Carolina, would you please stand right now? There's a few of you in the room. I want you to stay standing for a minute. Now, Tim, when Bobby Bowden was coaching football at Florida State, he used to tell his players, you know, the whistle blows signifies the end of a play. He told his players he wanted them to keep hitting until the last echo of the whistle was still reverberating. The last echo of the whistle signifying the end of the 2010 election just sounded at midnight last night because these people kept hitting. Yeah. And I want to tell you what they did. They passed a budget with bipartisan support that solved a $2.5 billion budget deficit that they inherited from their predecessors, predecessor, the largest budget deficit that any incoming General Assembly in the history of North Carolina has ever had to deal with. While they were closing a $2.5 billion budget gap, they cut taxes on North Carolinians by a little over $1 billion. They fully funded every teacher and teacher's assistant grades K through 12. They added 1,000 new teachers in grades 1 through 3, allowing class sizes to decrease by almost half there. They passed the budget in record time. And the reason that's important is every day they're up there, it's costing us money. They did it with increased transparency. Dale and George and Carolyn can tell you, Tom's a rookie, so he's not aware of this, but you know, the budget used to show up on their desk this high. The paper was still hot, the ink was still wet, and said, vote on this in 30 minutes. That's not how our Republicans dealt with the budget. People got the budget, had several days to look at it, and then there was unlimited debate. So not only did they make history this year, but the way they, by passing the budget, the way they did it should make all of you immensely proud. All the hard work that we went through in 2010 was worth it because of what these people, the job they finished last night after midnight. Now, I want to talk to you about that duty I mentioned for a minute. It is your duty to make sure that these people stay in the majority in the next election. Now, let me tell you how the Democrats refer to these people behind their back in the General Assembly. They call them one and done, meaning that Republicans getting control of the General Assembly was just a fluke in 2010. We're going to get it back in 2012. They'll be one and done. That's the way they act. They're still arrogant. They still think they're in control. They're still not through that state of denial. Ladies and gentlemen, it's not one and done. We have to keep these people in power because their work is not done. Not by anyone. And as I leave, with heartfelt thanks for the many friends in the room, as they're sitting down, don't give me a standing ovation, but I want you to give the General Assembly members of the Republican Party in North Carolina who have changed not only the history of our party, but the history of our state forever. Give them a standing ovation that will signify to them that you are accepting, personally and individually, your duty to return them to office. Thank you very much. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.